Hey, Dr. Backman here. Let's talk about taking a very simple Hello World program written in C++, compiling it with GCC, and then running it in a Unix-like operating system. Okay, let's go. So to start us off, I've created a basic Hello World program in C++, which you see here. If you want a breakdown of what it all means, you'll have to visit one of the other videos, which will walk through that process. But for now, we're ready to go. We can run with this. Now, one of the things you need to be aware of with C++ is that it's a compiled language. Now, that means that there's an extra step that has to happen between you writing the code and running it on the computer. This step is called compilation, and it turns your code into something that the computer can actually execute itself. Execute meaning to run. If you're familiar with languages like Python and JavaScript, those are interpreted languages, and they don't include this compilation step. Instead, the source code is passed through an interpreter every time the code is executed. This interpreter will at runtime evaluate the source code and produce instructions for the CPU based on what it finds. So, ultimately, there's this extra interpreter process sitting between your code and the CPU that does a lot of significant work every time you run your program. C++ is different. Again, it's a compiled language, which means there's a process called compilation that will take your source code and convert it into something that the CPU can execute before you ever run it. The result of compilation is an executable. Actually, there's a hidden step in there called linking, but that's a topic for a future video. The executable is a concise set of data and machine instructions. That's the base set of instructions that a CPU can execute. It will run quickly and efficiently directly on the CPU. Anytime you want to run your program, you simply run the executable. No additional compilation costs required. Unlike the interpreted languages, which always pay that interpreting cost at runtime. That's not to say that interpreted languages are bad. There's a lot of benefits there. One is portability. Your code will be able to run on any machine where an interpreter exists, rather than in a compiled language you might have to compile it for each new architecture you run on. The compiler we'll be using today is GCC, which stands for the GNU Compiler Collection, which, as the name implies, is a collection of compilers, one of which exists for C++, and you can access this by typing in at the terminal G++. From a terminal, you'll type in G++ and then the name of the file that you've created. In this case, our file is called hello_world.cpp, so G++ hello_world.cpp. That will initiate the process of having the G++ compiler consume your code and produce something machine executable. If compilation succeeds, meaning you've got no errors, then you won't see any output, but a file will be created for you, an executable file. The default name of this file is a.out. Now, of course, you can choose any other name you'd like for this file, but right now we'll be sticking with the defaults, a.out. With this file in hand, you can actually run your file with ./a.out, the name of your program. ./ means to execute something that exists within the current directory, and then you name that executable file. Hit enter, and you'll see the results of your program printed to the terminal. Success! And there you've compiled a simple Hello World C++ program. Very nice. Now it's your turn to take that code, do something a little bit different with it, make it your own, and see if you can compile and run it again. Have fun.